Realme 5 Pro. Well, it's not even been a year since its first launch, and here's Realme 5 Pro, an upgraded version to the Realme 3 Pro. Realme is on a launching spree and is trying to quickly bring new phones with sort of innovative features that are competitively priced and caters users' needs. So, let's look at what Realme 5 Pro has to offer and is it worth buying, especially when there is Redmi Note 7 Pro already launched and soon to be launched Redmi Note 8 Pro. You're watching Big Geek, and if this is your first time to my channel, please take a moment to click on that subscribe button. Also, if you enjoyed watching this review, don't forget to click that like button and share it with your friends. So guys, let's begin the review then. First, let's look at the build quality. Typically, it's the glass and glossy days for the phones, but the Realme 5 Pro sticks to the like old generation phones. The body is plastic, but the good thing is it's built solidly. Add to that, the weight of the phone is on the heavier side, weighing 184 grams, which can be a pro as well as con depending on the size of your hand. For me, I feel fine with the heavy phones since I'm used to holding larger screen phones. But the best thing to talk about here is just look at how gorgeous the mobile looks. Make sure to remove the stickers and all to reveal its all beauty and glory. I bought a crystal blue color. There is also crystal green color, which looks absolutely awesome in my opinion. Even the side of the phone has purple as well as pink gradient fusion. Now this can be without hesitant said beautifully crafted phone at this price point. This is the 4GB 64GB variant I have got here, dual SIM, plus you get the micro SD card expansion slot as well, and it also comes in 6GB 64GB and 8GB 128GB variants as well. You can check the link in the description for its pricing and all. So let's talk about the screen now. It boasts a 6.3 inch screen. The plus thing here is the display boasts a resolution of 1080 by 2340 pixels at 409 pixels per inch density, which is pretty good if you compare it to the other competitors. Although the Note 7 Pro from Redmi gets, or rather shares, same PPI density and same display. The display is quite bright in sunlight too. That's again a plus thing here. Although this is just another LCD display, I would say, but it does its job fine with its nice picture quality for video playbacks and everything else. The screen is Gorilla Glass 3 protected, and it also comes with screen guard attached. So yeah, I think Realme has covered pretty much everything with regards to display. When it comes to performance, listen to this. Now Realme has implemented new chipset, the Snapdragon 712 AIE, which is absolutely powerhouse and packs a punch, because it supports lots of stuff for your phone. But instead of Cryo 460 processor, which the Redmi Note 7 Pro has, with the Snapdragon 665 chipset of course, the Realme went with the Cryo 360 processor, which is a bit let down in my opinion. If we consider using it for the longer period of time, it can hamper the performance later as you use it more and more. The positive side however here is it doesn't consume a lot of battery, and the fact that it has Snapdragon 712 AIE, the performance is one of the best at this price point and more. So I haven't had any lag or stutter issues whatsoever so far. High-end gaming is also absolutely smooth most of the times, I will say. However, at times there were sudden drop in the frame rates, although very rare when playing continuously, you know, for hours and hours of gaming. You feel that little bit of stutter movements here and there. The call quality is fine, not so much complaints over here, depends on the signal too as well. So the speaker is also enough loud to be able to hear it properly while talking. Before we move on to the camera and my final verdict, let's talk about the battery first, because I'm really excited to tell the battery performance of this one. On a typical daily usage, like, you know, listening to music, watching videos, calling and playing games, clicking pictures, the phone can last easily 1.5 days with still some juice left. Remember, I haven't turned on the power saving mode yet, which means this phone can last more than 2 days if used smartly. So kudos to Realme for the software and apps optimization and ensuring that the battery backup is so great. If calling and watching video is the only thing you do mostly, then this phone can last easily more than 2 days. So that's how the battery backup is. There's also so many battery optimization features to get, you know, more battery backup and also boost the performance depending on what settings you choose. We'll make a separate video on it if you are interested, how to optimize battery on Realme 5 Pro. Make sure you are subscribed to my channel. Now let's talk about the ColorOS and its features. and later we will move to the camera category. Realme's ColorOS 6.0 of course comes with bloatware installed, lots of unnecessary apps, but there are some nice features which helps you in day-to-day life, like the screen recording, game space to optimize RAM for smooth functioning of the game. There is riding mode, driving mode, assistive wall, like rest to turn on screen, private safe and such things. You can also add watermark to your pictures. I mean, that's the rare thing that you get nowadays, because all you get the option is to, having the watermark of captured on Realme Pro, but you don't get to use your name there. But Realme gives you that option, again plus point there. So with all this said, next up is the camera, which I know you guys are waiting for. For me, I think it's kind of mixed bag. First of all, it has 48 megapixel main camera, which produces great images out of the box. But the problem is, and has been with not just Realme, but also with Xiaomi and other phones, is the fact that the images tend to be over sharpened all the time. It may look fake sometimes. If you are a pro photographer, you will instantly point it out. Otherwise, if you are a general user, the pics out of the box looks absolutely nice and really good, with enough details, noise reduction, and even the highlights as well as shadows are covered properly. But make sure to use tap to focus all the time if you want to, if you want properly exposed images. So that's the tip I can give you over there. Realme, if you are watching this video, tweak the image processing algorithm to make the images look cleaner rather than over sharpened. So that really helps. The star of this generation, Realme, is the ultra macro camera. It's just a 2 megapixel and quite a bit disappointing, I know. So most of the time the images tend to be blurred. Add to that, the bokeh effect is not implemented properly and it has to be 4 centimeters away from the subject, which actually doesn't give you macros, forget ultra macro. It is fine for casual photos, but not if you are serious and creative. Instead, watch my other video where I share you how to click macro without the macro camera. So link in the description. Make sure you subscribe for more tips and tricks videos. The depth sensor works well for portraits. The portraits or faces in general, sometimes it tends to be either hot as in warm looking, or at other times it exposes cooler temperature, making pics look over sharp and wrong color. Hold it properly to get accurate looking pictures. Otherwise, the color temperature doesn't give you right all the time, especially for faces, I'm saying. So the ultra wide camera again here is really handy and gives social media shareable pictures. The electronic stabilization while taking video works pretty good if you are not running but walking. Yes, if you are running, again it starts to quite wobble, but still if you are walking, it's just fine. The video quality is also fine for the price you are paying. Now there is also chroma boost, which slightly enhances the images, and also the expert mode opens up new world and gives flexibility to click accurate color looking images with white balance tweak and the night images as well. But the problem again here is with the software algorithm, which can be fixed with the update on how it looks after you have taken the picture. Guys, if you are watching this review, make sure you tweet it to the Realme, make sure you tweet my video to Realme so that they see this one and give you a proper update, to get some really nice looking images. So all in all, the camera is excellent for casual photography. Next up is the audio quality and the speaker output. Again here, there is not really much to complain. The audio quality and speaker output volume is fine for the price, nothing to complain about here really. The face as well as fingerprint unlock works really great and is super fast, absolutely no hiccups even in while you are trying to unlock at night. Again, there is VOOC charging, which is another plus point for this phone. The phone charges very, very quickly and be able to add it for another day, which is absolutely awesome. So guys, with all this said, here's my final verdict. But before that, if you have made it till here, please consider subscribing to my channel and hit that like button and share it with your friends. So the final verdict: excellent battery backup, superb performance for the price, and decent camera makes this a great buy. WikiGeek highly recommends this phone. I would suggest you buy the 6GB 64GB variant. And what do you guys think about this phone? Let me know in the comment section down below. Are you guys going to buy it after watching this, or if you have already bought it? Alright guys, everyone, see you all in another one. Till then, take care everyone. Bye bye.